Hello and welcome back to part 2 of creating a Gantt chart in Google Sheets. Today we'll add the most requested feature from part 1, hiding or showing weekends. Plus we'll add options to customize your workdays and account for weekends in your tasks. To follow along, use your spreadsheet from part 1 or download the free template linked in the description. This video includes some advanced techniques, so don't hesitate to pause or rewind as needed. Now let's jump in. First, I want to update the dates from the original template. We'll start by linking task 1 to the project start date by entering equals G2 for the start date of task 1. Then I'll enter the start date. We won't be using the weekly dates in row 3, so I'll clear its formatting. Google Sheets can be a little stubborn, so I'll also switch the number format to automatic. Next, I'll remove the cell borders in row 4 with a cool keyboard shortcut. I'm going to update the date format to day, month, and year, and change the text rotation to rotate up. Finally, I'll increase the row size so it fits nicely. Now that we have our days set up, it's time to add the ability to only show workdays. The first way we can do this is with a 7-number string representing the days of the week, where 0s are workdays and 1s are non-workdays. We'll name this cell using the name box and call it workdays_option. This allows us to easily reference this cell in the formulas we'll be writing. We'll be using the workday international function that takes into account the weekends or non-workdays we just set up. We'll set the start date to the first date in the row, the number of days to 1, and then reference the workdays option cell to tell the formula what days of the week we've set up as non-workdays. Don't forget to end with a parentheses. Now we'll drag that formula over for all the days to the right. Notice that now no Saturdays or Sundays are being shown. Let's make customizing the non-workdays more interactive and intuitive by adding the days of the week with a checkbox under each day. Now we can populate the workdays option cell with the results of the checkboxes by using the join function. As a default, the checkboxes give the response of true and false. So I'll go into Data, Data Validation, select the checkboxes, and set custom values of 1 for checked and 0 for unchecked. Now I'll test things out to make sure they're working. Looks good. Next up, I want to create an easy way to toggle showing or hiding the non-workdays. Above workdays, I'll add the text show weekends and place a checkbox in the cell next to it. For easy reference when writing formulas, I'll name this checkbox cell show_weekends. Now I'll update the date row formula to use an if function. If show weekends is true, make this cell show the day after the cell on the left. Don't forget the additional parentheses needed at the end. I'll drag that new formula to the right, and now the checkbox lets me hide or show the non-workdays. Let's make the weekends easier to see by using conditional formatting to highlight them. Select the dates in the day letter rows, then go to Format, Conditional Formatting, and we'll add a new rule. Under Format Rules, I'll select Custom Formula Is, and use the NETWORKDAYS.INTL function to identify which cells are non-workdays. We have to use absolute references to get this to work properly. I'll lock in cell P3, which is my workdays option, and then the row 4 dates, so that the days of the week in row 5 highlight. Now I'll adjust the formatting so it looks better with my current design. Let's test things out to make sure they're working. Show weekends looks good, and notice your non-workdays don't have to be Saturday and Sunday. I'll speed this section up as I make this user interface better match the design of my Gantt chart. Task dates, days, and bars aren't yet set up to consider the non-working days. For example, watch as I update the first task's start date. The days column says 3 days, but the end date and the bar on the right are still using weekends as workdays. Let's fix that by making the start date and the days column be for user entry, and then auto-calculate the end date. In the end date cell, I'll use the workday international function. I'll choose the task start date for the start date, the days column for the number of days, subtract 1 so it includes the start day as the first day of the task, and use our name cell workdays option so it uses the non-workdays we've already defined. Now the end date and the bar on the right are correctly factoring in the non-working days. To help remind us that the end date is not a user entry point, I'll make the background gray. Then I'll copy this cell down to update the rest of the end date cells. The last thing I'll do is update the days column title to be more accurate and say workdays. I hope this video has helped you make your Gantt chart even more powerful and that you've learned some great spreadsheet skills along the way. If you liked this video, please help us out by giving it a like and subscribing to our channel.